look at?
Mm-hmm.
How was it going?
Was it good well reason?
Original piece, but tell me what you think of it.
be sure to lock down the door. For he is one man that doesn't need a blackboard or chalk. Asking Torrance is the easy part. Retaining the vast amount of knowledge and expenses is just the start. The start of a conversation that will be filled with very few abbreviations and avenues to get away from a sea of knowledge and reminders as he begins the lecture.
You're something wrong, man.
A lecture that no university teacher could match. He is a walking encyclopedia, witty with words, and looks faster than a Mac or iPhone or anything I, in fact, he's iTorrance, or any smart devices you can name. There is no shame in saying that this man makes university graduates question how much they know, for all they have to show is a certificate saying that they can learn. But Torrance, he is learned. He is the epitome of student for life. If life spoke, it would be a voice, and not like Torrance. A voice of knowledge, a voice of wisdom, a voice of understanding and zero contradictions. If you ask Torrance about his long-standing career in the insurance field, you should yield perhaps an assurance that he has no regrets. His successful career is equivalently matched by his decades of dedication to the arts. His dedication is unmatchable.
Ah, but yeah, stuff like knowledge, wisdom, and dedication. I think you're in the end of the calendar.
I hope so. This final page, I think, it's my view. It's my view of the page. So listen at that one. If you ask Tom, how he has survived the challenges he has faced in establishing the San Fernando Arts Council. With that familiar smirk, he will say, principles. Decades of principles and zero luck. For he's one who sees luck as opportunity meeting preparedness. One of his favorite quotes.
And there's no such thing
like luck. Oh yes! Opportunity meeting preparedness. Love is created, not given. If you ask Torrance about life and wife, he becomes counselor, relationship specialist, specializing in the art of love. His nuggets in this department is simply lovely. If you are a dancer willing to learn more, ask Torrance. If you are a dramatist in need of guidance, ask Torrance. If you are a musician in need of an ear, ask Torrance. Asking Torrance is always an opportunity to learn, to improve yourself, and perhaps above all, he does what you do, freely, expecting of him. He has an acronym. He always gives you an acronym, something to remember when by. Even your name, when you spell out your name and he'll give you words for each letter of your name. So that you know, of course, he's the type of man, you know, to make a fee of words every single time. So I have something I put together here.
Something like that.
Spell out his name. Tell me what you think about it.
Okay.
Torrance, the talisman. A man takes a little and can make a lot out of it. Torrance the orator, a man who is never lost for words. Torrance the riddler, a man who can keep you guessing. Torrance the resilient, a man who has withstood the test of time and trials. Torrance the arsenal, a man loaded with the right weapons for every battle, a true warrior. Torrance the natural, a man who has been naturally trained, self-taught. Torrance the courageous, a man who has unlimited courage. Torrance the encyclopedia, a man who knows so much about so much. If you don't believe me, ask Torrance.
You know, I think you have a lot of this.
Well, I'll read it for them at the Creative Art Center. There we go. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. While I can smell them, and you know, tonight I take this opportunity to thank you for the tremendous input you have made in my life, you have given to me and my friend down here tonight. Thank you so much, Mr. Torrance. May God continue to richly bless you. Thank you.
All of those persons who rush in here on a daily basis to ask. 33 years now. It's been 33 years. So to sit here now, we hope that whatever would come out of this year, tonight, will just be another stepping stone for far greater things for the arts, and the artists, and for opportunities like this to become something that all the public will want to listen to and subscribe to and will want to know about. I think Mr. Clifton, Hollis Clifton, has been doing an exceptional job of trying to break this. Mr. Clifton, of course, Ms. Regis, I think they deserve a round of applause for this audience. Because we seem to be the state of flux in the arts, because in my day, a room like this would have been filled. And Sanfest was a massive thing, it was the talk of the town. After school, you would be rushing home to make sure you get to see the Sanfest presentation. So I'm hoping that we're just in the state of flux and that we'll be moving forward and we'll be tossing our concerns ears and listen, because we need the business community to come in. But of course, we ask Torrance about more. I'm here proposing my first question to Torrance about the state of the art, of the arts, in particularly in Trinidad, and also that in San Fernando. The National Drama Festival has not been on for a long time. I see the secondary school drama festival is on. There has been no awards functions or anything to recognize the work of artists. I'm talking about actors, songwriters, singers, dancers, playwrights, etc., or production houses. None of that you're seeing anymore. One time they were holding it in the Carol Theatre, then they were holding it at the Central Band Auditorium, Queen's Hall. In my day, it was a gala event. That's no more. We are not seeing any publicities of any of the productions in such an energetic way as we've seen, say, 20, 25 years ago. I'm deeply concerned because returning now full time to the arts, I'm a little concerned as to where do we go from here? Because I'm seeing something that I'm witnessing something that is a great concern to me. This, of course, is my first question. For those of you who wish to ask Torrance, for the sake that we have a small crowd on hand here, maybe what we can do is to take the microphone. For those of you who have a question, just put it to the table. For the sake of Hollis, is that all right, Hollis?
Yeah.
For the sake of you to capture it.
Yes.
The question. All right? So we can just, or we can bring them to the center. We can bring them to the center. You can stand there and pose your question right there. Everyone can hear.
Better yet.
Better still. So we can take it to the center. And you will hold the microphone and those will pose the question. State of the arts, Mr. Moore.
Okay. I have to make up that one.
Motivation gave me purpose. Destiny gave me an agenda. And the Lord gave me His presence. Thank you very much. I'm overwhelmed, really flattered, and humbled by this gesture. I want to make it public that it is well appreciated that you could have, you know, taken time to give recognition for a very humble person, very simple, who have made his contribution in the journey of life in all aspects of human endeavor. Now, let me start.
Thank you.
I was able to get the acceptance of the guys was formed in 1969. And our first Sanfest was in 1970. So we already celebrated 45 years, 70 of Sanfest. We started both seniors and juniors together. And as we moved along later on, we thought that we should start the junior festival, taking up the slack. And Trinidad and Tobago arts festival, as well as well associated themselves.
Concept, the idea.
gym. And so the most people came to secondary schools.
Thank you. So we have a question now.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening once again. Mr. Torrance, I know with your wealth of experience and contribution to the arts, you'll be able to answer this question. One of my issues as a very young actor is marketability of drama productions. How is there a way that you can suggest to market productions, not just drama productions, but even an event like this? What is the issue in marketing such an event? We're doing almost every event we have, it's very difficult to market itself. This challenge and improve the attendance.
Well, marketability, it starts with you. It starts with you, your family, and your friends. Apart from it, technological apparatus and things like that. It starts to start with you. You have to sell yourself. You will tell them that you're coming here and you're part of this, and you can. Sometimes you have to know your friends, your parents, your brothers and sisters. None of your relatives, so it has to start from you, your relatives, your friends, and to the wider population. The school, your place of work, we use the medium of, the medium of radio, television, etc., etc. The master market of things. One of the most powerful Trinidad words in the dictionary. A, from a biblical perspective, ask and you shall receive, seek and you shall find, knock and you shall enter the kingdom of heaven. Is that right? I'm not a Christian, but that's a biblical thing. Right? Ask, it's something that you can tell God's conscience. But you never ask it, you never apply it. Same parallel A is for attitude. You develop a positive, winning mental attitude. No matter what happens in your good and bad things, but you try to overcome that by developing a positive, winning mental attitude. And the A and the S is for skills. You keep developing your skills, your techniques. And for the monkeys, it's for sincerity. Whatever you're doing, you must be sincere. And K is for knowledge. The knowledge of yourself, the knowledge of your family, your community, your country, your region, and the world over. Because sometimes we live in Ireland and we think small. We are citizens of the world, and we are also curriculum leaders. But although we are surrounded by water, some of them are invisible. So, if I report the question of marketability, it takes different avenues and proportions to develop marketability. And to really set it, you can set it yourself. You have to improve in what you give your work, whether it is
poses a serious challenge through film media, ranging from programs on Disney Channel and all of that. So people are very it's easier to view entertainment through television and cable channels. This is coming out to an evening of live performances. How can we strike the right balance between film and performing arts and maintain an appetite or encourage an appetite from the population to attend events as such?
For 16 years, and
want to politic, but everybody in a politician.
Yeah.
Sometimes when you can advance or change, you are a politician. Take for instance.
Well, I think Torrance, unless people should be politicians, I think, you know, everybody who gets it, they suddenly would want to see themselves as a politician. Some people are asking me why I want to get into politics. I have no interest in it. I think we can all serve our country, serve each other, serve our community exactly where we sit now. We don't need to be a politician today.
Yeah, but why individually we could strong? Collectively we could be better.
Yeah. We have to
unite.
That was my message, I think, when we were this. We got to unite. Nobody's going to listen to us.
Okay.
Now,
why do I have the love for the arts? You still have to get a job. before you go to separate me, before you go there and try to accuse people of anything, look in the mirror, make sure that your family situation went in order before you still committing. Nothing is wrong. So I got involved in community, in joining a dance company, sell insurance, motivated man.
Never.
Both.
He changed it for the last time.
Yeah.
When he had the map, revolution.
Living rooms, but there was no pressure to protect what was ours. We almost lost the family.
you have to go on tour today, you have to do your work.
We have another question.
It's going to light, please.
No, I don't think so.
you need to check a number of times what you accept in the center. So and it depends on your background, the school you go to, and the kind of encouragement you get from the teacher. Yeah? But at the same time, yeah, the news where you draw from, you know, movies, television, and then I learned a lot from going to shows. I used to go to see shows at Queen's Hall and from the board. And remember that time to go to Queen's Hall, it was so cold there, you have to get a suit. But I couldn't afford a suit, I started to borrow a jacket in those days, $80. Okay? But if I have time, but it doesn't matter. You mustn't have support that kind of inferiority complex, because you're from quite a way, you're quite from all the world. I was born in the south. It's not from the world. I'm not from the rest of the world. And television.
We have one more question.
Good afternoon, everyone again. But I'm the productive artist transport in back to Charles Marley. A long time ago, the arts and dance was a big thing. I'm getting this one word now, was a big thing. Everyone excited. You had relationships with people from other groups. And so therefore, there was a wide turnout. For this production today, 20 dance completers were invited to send 5 members. 20 schools, that is secondary school, dance education teachers and theatre arts teachers were invited to send 5 students through telephone calls, through social media, through invitations, and Mr. Marvin, I wanted to share your impression on that concern as to why dance education teachers or leaders of dance group, and I don't think we're top over their members, why they can't impress, why haven't they been able to impress upon their members the importance of attending this seminar where the majority of those dance leaders came here to you for information or for recommendations. In addition to that, what advice would you give to young people who attend seminars and during the seminar spend the majority of the seminar on social media? Those are my questions to you.
Why is he empty women? It's a big compare.
Gil Hall.
Yeah, I put it in. No, we thought that we should aspire to build our own place where we can have people come in to create and you have a own set and what to do with something for everyone and things like that. Jack Gopak is, and we got some assistance from the Yerel Mahavir, got this part from us by the minister, and we will put it in the set. But while we get very little support from people, and we only get a real estate $1 a year. It's only to pay 1 month salary to our workers here and for our agent in for the months. So we have to use, you know, when you go to this management, remember themselves used to get to work with us when we rented on weekends. But we had no choice, we had to rent it on the weekends and try to sell it something. They made a little revenue from the weddings and other things to pay for the upkeep of this book. So you see, that could be
up. Before I ask Torrance to give his closing remarks, folks, I just want to add this, just give me 3 minutes to do this. Back in 1997, four prisoners came to me outside of Trinidad and Tobago television. And they wanted to tell their story and they wanted to start a group. We got together, we formed a group, it was called Vision and Mission. We were just four of the boys and borrow clothes and that sort of thing.
Wayne Chance.
It was myself, Wayne Chance, Gary Grant, Callum Craig, and one other. And the first thing that we sat down when we sat down together, we opened a bank account at Republic Bank. And then, on my television show, we started to promote the bank account. And every week, they would have to tell their story. And we would ask people to participate in what we're doing. We gained sympathy from various business spaces. We went to government, and at that time, we were trying to see what we could do before they pick up anybody to do it. So we asked the public to donate to our business account. And I said, if they're to treat us like a serious business, then we must form a board. I didn't even sit on the board, I called for various people. The prisons commissioner, businessmen, people who wanted to volunteer to be part of the board, and we formed a board that started making executive decisions for us. But we made Wayne as the president, because Wayne was made the face. I was the driver. In the first month, we had about $40,000, and we went on the border cars. We would go around the schools to tell kids about our work, about staying out of trouble, staying out of violence, etc., etc. Today, it's recognized by the government of Trinidad and Tobago, who receive us a pension. We're we call it an NGO. The United Nations, we're recognized as the United Nations. Wayne Chance is now the United Nations ambassador. We only lost one boy, and the other one before was a boy called Clifton. Only one boy didn't have the patience with our fighting. He was shot and killed in the room, but he went back to fight. But today we were 1,700 strong. We never lost another prisoner since then. Our boys are now working. One of them, Gary Grant, was in jail. Now in the Ministry of National Security, he wanted to be a policeman. And he had no life. The story I learned from those boys that were going to prison to show young people and working with those young men was that nothing is insurmountable. I said that here the other day. Nothing is impossible. But we've got to approach it like a business before people take us serious. We've got to show that we're serious before they take us serious. And that was the only time Vision and Mission started. When we started to form ourselves together into a board, generate our own money, open a bank account, once in a month talk to our bank, go and talk to people, knock on doors, ask them to help, this is what we're doing. Some will ignore you. No, you take it on. And there's some who will take you seriously and they will say, here's a check. And then I invite them to sit with the board, come on TV with me, or go before the newspapers. This man gave me money. This organization gave me money, and I'm making sure that they're standing there with Wayne and Gary and everybody else, collecting that check to show them. Because the Ramians have their publicity, they want to know what they're going to get out of it, and that's what we got to understand from the business community. We've got to tell them something in return. This is not a pain. You tell them they owe it to the arts, they'll tell you it's off. But you tell them that there is something to gain from this, that when they hand over that check, that Mr. Brady is standing here with them, another way for the church to come. We have to close them, be with them, work with them for the first stages. After that, it starts to run smooth. I didn't have to do a single thing for Bishop Michelle again. The day everybody knocks out Wayne Chance's door, everybody wants to be part of
it. It's over to
you. United Nations recognized. Wayne is an entrepreneur. Wayne is unsure. We have to be building a women's facility right now. If you go on Facebook, the women's facility is built. We have 40 acres of land. We have a building there where the boys are now being housed with dogs and everything for troubled kids. That building is up.
Okay.
That building is up. And it was named after its foundation members. They all is handsome as well. The John Rocher, Dawn, everybody who ended up doing that time, Ramesh works for us and others as well. And there's a section there for Ramesh works for us. But the fact is, all these things happen. All these things happen today. Wayne is married to a partner who used to run bands. He has two sons, handsome boys. Wayne drives. Wayne has three cars. Wayne has just built a beautiful home for his wife. His wife designed the car. And when she started to go out in the back of the fire truck, he's like United Nations ambassador traveling the world telling his story today and all these prisoners. And we have a safe house as well in Sharpe for boys who look like they can't make it out. We have best Caribbean being in Sharpe. I'll show you a minute. So we're going to see them being sold for Carnival and other places. We started a restaurant, catering business, etc. Prisoners teaching. Folks, moral of the story, we had approached it like a business, we had to come together, now we want to walk with people, we want to know about things.
That's my
kind of story, I'm passionate about it, and I hope I don't take over this thing and make up ass hands. But this is just something I've had 30 years of this. And I just want to share that with you all since we have a captive audience for the first time. You all are my people, you all are our artists. I am one of your boys.
I mean, in our course of the exercise, we get to recognize our recently King and Queen here of Sanfest. And the question of Ms. Sanfest, would you, from Nova, so that you understand.
Started coming up with ideas of a little group with how we're gonna do Sec, otherwise known as Sanfest Essential Secondary. I never know the school, and ironically, I didn't know this building was called. But coming into the chimney of Sanfest, I realized that this place here has produced great people, great talented people. I've seen diversity, different people from different walks of life utilizing this building, and it was something to be really inspiring. And still, I must say, in the very moment I had a conversation with you, I got that father figure, grandfather figure, as I didn't really have that grandfather figure. So by that little 5 minutes of you talking, it was very much appreciated, and instantly I realized that you have a wealth of knowledge that can be shared, that needs to be heard by every youth. Give me some few tips that I plan to use for the rest of my life, except always be cordial to everyone, smile, and most of all have community, and you'll begin to look younger even though you're aging. And I will say you're a testimony to that statement soon.
Bro.
So Torrance performed for 7 minutes in the title category of the Senior Sanfest Pageant Jubilee and Global Seniors Presentation on that day.
Pageant winner.
then Mr. Mabay actually forced me to enter the show trees before the show then. So anything I enter, I want to win. So I am informed that I want to be the winner, and it's about a code. Actually, it's a competition, it's a friendly venture, and so therefore, everyone is aware of the criteria, so there's no cheating. It is a very competition. Somebody will lose, somebody will win, but we were all the winners in that year. He placed third, and of course he was a winner, and he continues to be a winner. Now I want to invite the other boys, who will be the first person on stage. Alright, that's the idea.
Get a teeth deal.
She would like the night to also tell a story. Actually, Steve had a secondary school drama category as a certificate of excellence. So she was a night bulb. You know why? You know what? One poor character, they were the night bulb. Or Jim. Actually, they were no man.
Yes, the same moment is Best shit waters, when I tell you, best Out of water, he would desperately gasp for air, choking and drowning in the bloody red with his eyes.
one shot, two shots, three shots and four. Your forefathers will turn in your grave once more because God knows this is not the freedom that they fought for. Bloody shots. Father buried them in his son's blood. The red sea will also pour forth from his eyes, and his cries will be compressed and pour to the heavens the words of the heart the lungs cannot process. The pain and agony in his lips cannot confess. Hopes and dreams that maybe someday their sons will come back to them. Maybe somehow they will grow up to become men. Their black skins will only leave marks of white tuxedos. Because somewhere between the cracks of two walls a flower will still grow. And it will blossom. They will blossom to become kings of empires and rulers of kingdoms. And maybe one day, mothers will smile again. The kind of smile that stays dark. Boys may draw our lines on my son. She will forgive him. Because right next to Christ is two crosses. The thieves are murderers of men, one of which they go for absent. But you remember me and enter the kingdom. Boys, the boys who may draw our lines on my son. She will forgive him. She will pray for him. Because there is a God. There is a God who has already.
Thank you, Mr. Charles. I want to encourage the young persons who are here today to go back to your school and inquire and ask your dance education teachers and your theatre arts teachers, ask why they were not here today. I await your response, because tomorrow I'll be asking them Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Some of them are going by calls. They say, what is he calling me for? And they needed to be here today. Not because some of them might say they have more information, but I'm sure they didn't know maybe 95% of what was discussed today. On Sunday the 22nd at 4 p.m., you can see this young man on the Power of Talent, the past Mr. and Mrs. Sanfest Delegate Show.
And those are the spokespeople.
came from dance education teachers who have taken to today's activity. Maybe they were calling to tell me why they couldn't come, or to ask me how it went. So that is part of my concerns in planning the senior Sanfest pageant, realizing that we do need member groups' participation. Inside of here, there are 12 dance companies that operate in the San Fernando Arts Council Creative Arts Building. All of them was my close target. Where are they today? That is my concern. Where are the leaders of the groups that have performed? Adana is asking herself that question. Adana, can you share what group you came from?
Our dance group.
Today she was asking me where the other members were. They were all informed individually. And you need to be here. What they say is, Adana here, so they don't need to come. It's very important. What group you came from, my dear? And that group is led by the Pentecostal, one of our delegates. I know she's at present, she's at UB at present. What school you came from?
Three
months high school. I also called her a dance education teacher. And this is her mommy carrying that message back tomorrow at Sarah's Brian. Yes, at Sarah's. Just to make sure. What dance club you came from? That's mine. I can tell my members to cut something. When they come to join my group, they know what is required. Look behind what I hear. She was one of the purpose group leaders who indicated a month and a half ago that I'd be getting these performances. She stayed true to her word. There were other four leaders who told me I'd have performances today. So that's one of the reasons I didn't do any programs. I didn't put them to come. Yeah, but that's true now. But you were in about this last night, right? When I told you outside there, and you didn't come, or not really late, you tell me I didn't get any more of it. See, you didn't get any more of it, and it's fine, keep too bad. I found the experience was not too bad.
It's really,
really informative. Oh, yeah, because I knew it was actually informative.
Do you think you had all the answers at all? You know, you used to be like that before, thinking that you know all that. But this time I cut it down to science and then they did not know how much more you have to learn.
Yeah.
More than that.
So you intend to do that?
Really think about stuff.
Well, let me pass the meeting up to me now. To meet your man, you are here today. I told you about this activity about a week and a half ago, and you did turn up. And so therefore, let me hear your views and your opinion.
I believe that this session was really informative. I believe that a wealth of knowledge was shared. And I know that Mr. Torrance has a lot more to share. In terms of his points, session, I think that it should have been, a lot of people should have taken the initiative to be here, knowing the type of person that Mr. Torrance is and the type of legacy that he has left and is still leaving along the street in terms of the arts. And what he has to share, it would help us in some way or to continue to keep the arts alive, not only in Trinidad, but
are you impressed by today? What impressed you?
I was very impressed. I learned a lot from Mr. Torrance Mohammed's speech. A lot of the words that he said about Trinidad and San Fernando, the original names. And I really enjoyed being here. I wish more people would have attended and really been a part of this session. And I think the arts really needs to be revived.
Thank you, Tanya. Would you encourage one of the other leaders? The 15 who danced and sat
Well, I should say the powers that be
team, we all have tomorrow's leaders, and we have some great leaders ahead of us here. Keep it up. God bless you.
And sure, as we close the Mr. Stevens presentation, I would like to read from this text that Mr. Muhammad asked me to read. That most of us know this. In whatever religion you have been taught, however you have been brought up, and however you have understood your teachers by these levels, you will understand and grasp this message. It is not enough that this message be believed. It is a message to be lived. The essence of universal religion is peace and truth, but love for and kindness for all the creatures of the earth. Now is the time to express this essence in your own life. A beginning must be made, and the place to begin with, and is yourself. You will reform the world. Begin with yourself, brother. The message of the unreformed reformer seldom inspires reformation. The heart of all religion is love, and righteousness, which is love in action, is the fulfillment of religion. Love not only family and friends, for love limited is love denied. Seek peace within yourself and seek too within yourself the divine bread of life. Persist in these prayers. Do not let up for a single moment. Through your faith and through your deeds, you shape your life and help shape the lives of others as well. What a responsibility. The spirit Christ in you is agent and also its partner. And to the degree that you are aware of this and act on it, your life is enriched. A revelation will occur to you, a revelation higher than your most exalted dreams. The new age is coming, and in it, there will be a realization of the oneness of all. Differences between the various religions will disappear. The good, which is in each of them, will be fused and will become common goal of all mankind. Know that you have the power to choose. Choose love, not hate. Choose gentleness, not violence. Choose holiness, not evil. Dare to believe that the reign of love and peace is coming soon. Ready yourself for it. Ready yourself for it with deeds of righteousness. Righteousness is the door opener, and beyond the door is love. May power divine enter every aspect of your life, endowing it with the rewards of material accomplishments, the treasures of purposeful existence, and the eternal life of spirit, enlightenment. This is the desert.